the MPF scheme and so on. So that's why it takes time to deal with such matters. Thank you.
Government bills. First reading, Employment Amendment Bill 2018. Second reading, Secretary for Labour and Welfare. Madam Deputy, I move the second reading of the Employment Amendment Bill 2018. The bill seeks to increase the duration of statutory paternity leave under the ordinance from 3 days to 5 days. Statutory paternity leave has been made a statutory benefit for male employees since the 27th of February 2015. The government undertook to review the implementation of paternity leave 1 year after its coming into operation. The Labour Department has conducted the review and consulted the Labour Advisory Board and Panel on Manpower of the Legislative Council, which are supportive of the proposal. The proposed bill is drawn up on the basis of the review findings of the implementation of PL and the support from the Labour Advisory Board and the Panel on Manpower. The proposal will help male employees better discharge their family responsibility around the time of their children's birth. The bill proposes to increase the statutory paternity leave benefit of the relevant employee from 3 days to 5 days. In other words, if the bill is passed, an eligible working father with a newborn will enjoy 2 more days of paternity leave on top of the 3 days currently provided under the ordinance. We propose to increase the paternity leave duration to 5 days, having considered the manpower situation and the ability of employers to afford employee benefits. Some industries or enterprises may be more labor-intensive, such as the catering industry. Furthermore, 98% of enterprises in Hong Kong are small to medium enterprises, SMEs, and these employers may face more significant impact. From the Labour Department survey, it is found that the majority of SMEs and microenterprises surveyed can cope with 5 days of paternity leave. While some employers have indicated difficulties in manpower arrangements, the majority should be able to cope with the resource and manpower implications from 2 more days of PL. Other key features of the paternity leave mechanism will remain unchanged, such as the rate of paternity leave pay shall remain at 4/5 of the employee's average daily wages. Service requirement of a male employee for entitlement to paternity leave pay, notification requirement, documentary proof to be provided to employers, and time frame for payment of paternity leave paid by employers. In general, both employers and employees have not encountered difficulties in the operation of the mechanism. I wish to point out that the current proposal submitted by the government is a result of careful consideration, having taken fully into account the impact on employers and employees and the consensus forged between employer members and employee representatives in the Labour Advisory Board. Increasing the duration from 3 to 5 days is the only proposal accepted by both sides. The consensus reached between employers and employees has not come easy and must be duly acknowledged by the government. Increasing the paternity leave duration from 3 to 5 days is also the only proposal the government finds acceptable, as the objective of the bill is simple and direct. That is, raising the number of paternity leave days to 5 days, which is different from other more complex bills. I sincerely urge members to consider not having to set up a bills committee for this bill on paternity leave with such a simple and direct objective so that the bill can be passed as soon as possible. I urge members not to set up a bills committee so that the resumption of second reading can take place at the last council meeting of this year on the 11th of July. And even after the bill is passed, because of the summer recess, we'll need to wait for the first council meeting of the Legislative Council after summer recess before tabling the effective dates of operation of the bill into the council and through appropriate channels. We hope that fathers with newborns for 2019 will be able to enjoy 2 more days of paternity leave. However, if a bills committee is to be set up, then because of summer recess, the earliest opportunity would be at the House committee for the bills committee's report to be endorsed before resumption of second reading of the bill takes place. And that would mean fathers of newborns who are born in the year of the pig can enjoy the two more days of paternity leave. Well, I understand that members may have other views on the amendment bill, and some members may wish to move amendments, but I think that all these views can be resolved and expressed during the resumption of second reading of the bill. I emphasize that increasing the duration from 3 to 5 days is the only acceptable solution to the government. I now propose the question to you that the Employment Amendment Bill 2018 be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the Bills Committee.